إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم مثل الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله كمثل حبة أنبتت سبع سنابل في كل سنبلة 100 حبة والله يضاعف لمن يشاء والله واسع عليم الذين ينفقون أموالهم في سبيل الله ثم لا يتبعون ما أنفقوا منا ولا أذى لهم أجرهم عند ربهم ولا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون أما بعد. Dear brothers and sisters, we begin by praising Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We send peace and blessings upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his companions, upon all those who have treaded in their footsteps of righteousness and piety. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he makes us from those who follow in the teachings and the footsteps of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the teachings and footsteps of the Sahaba radiallahu anhum, and that he makes us from those who follow in their practices. Ameen. Alhamdulillah, last week, Sunday, we had our fundraiser. And after the fundraiser, you know, all of us were very, very happy with the results. Just so everyone is aware, our goal for the fundraiser was to collect $400,000. That $400,000 would, all of it would be used for the expansion of the masjid. Alhamdulillah, last week, through your generosity, we were able to collect over $250,000. That is a large amount. And once again, we thank everyone for their donation, for their contribution. And many of us over here may have given just $1. Many of us, maybe every time we come into the masjid, we give $5 or whatever the case. Many of us don't have any extra money to give. But what we do is we give our time. And whatever contribution you're making, whatever you're giving, whether it's money, whether it's time, whether it's volunteering yourself for some sort of service, all that is something that we appreciate. Alhamdulillah. We appreciate it, and on top of that, it's something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appreciates, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not overlook any of your contributions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not overlook any of your contributions. In fact, just being present, coming for the Jummah Salah, coming for the daily Salah, allowing your children to attend the Sunday school, this in itself is a way of contributing to the masjid. Because if the community knows that the masjid is in use, more people will come. If our masjid is not in use, if the masjid is something which we only come to once a week, once a month, or once a year, then the rest of the people in the community that may want to come to the masjid on a daily basis will say, what's the point of going? The masjid may not be open. So us being here, just being here in a way is a contribution. It's a donation of your time. So the point is, dear brothers and sisters, that we are very grateful to have such a beautiful community. To have a beautiful community that goes out of their way to spend for the masjid. That goes out of their way to come and sit in the masjid, spend their time as well. So the fundraiser has passed, alhamdulillah. And again, we thank everyone. We make dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blesses you with much more than you've given. And in today's khutbah, inshallah, what we'd like to go over are the rewards of the people that give, right? Fundraiser is over, so we're not asking for more. We're reminding everyone of those who have given or those who have the intention to give that, you know, why did we give? Why did we give? Or what's the purpose for giving and why should we continue to give? You know, there's something in sales called buyer's remorse. A nice salesperson comes to you and he talks you up. He says, yeah, this is the best thing you can buy. You know, spend all your life savings on it. And the person is such a good salesperson, he makes you buy it. And then you go home and then 2-3 days later you're thinking, man, I made such a dumb mistake. It's called buyer's remorse. Right there and then the salesperson really, you know, gave you the best pitch in the world. That this is what you have to buy. If you don't have this in your life, then, you know, you're not living, right? They make you think that. And you end up buying it. 2-3 days later, you're like, what did I do? I have no more money left, right? And this thing is not even benefiting me. So people have buyer's remorse. But when you give to the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you give to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no such thing as buyer's remorse. Why? Because you know that what you gave will be given back in double, inshallah. I'm going to turn this mic on, inshallah, it won't make any noise. So when you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is no such thing as buyer's remorse, because you get it back, inshallah. In the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions, مَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ كَمَثْلِ حَبَّةٍ أَنْبَتَتْ سَبَعَ سَنَابِلَ فِي كُلِّ سُنْبُلَةٍ مِئَةُ حَبَّةٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the example of the person who spends his wealth for the pleasure, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, like many of us have and are still doing for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in assisting our masjid. The example of it is كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ, is like the example, is like the example of a seed which is planted into the ground. This one seed that you plant into the ground, this one contribution that you make, from this one contribution, from this one seed, what happens? أَنْبَتَتْ سَبَعَ سَنَابِلِ. From this one seed, sanabil is actually a year, not a year, but a year of corn, right? When you have, if you ever see a corn, how corn grows, you'll notice that you have the corn, the stem, and then from it other pieces of corn grow, and it's called a ear of corn. So from this one grain of corn, 7 ears of corn have sprouted. From this one contribution of yours, 7 other things have sprouted. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, not only that, fi kulli sunbulatin mi'atu habba, and in each one of these ears of corn, there are 100 more seeds. Meaning for all these seeds, you can replant again. And if you replant again, then you'll have acres and acres of grains, of corn, whatever it may be. This is the example which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving us. That you may think your contribution to the masjid is once. You may think your contribution to the masjid is just one small seed. You know, what am I doing giving $5? This is a $1 million project. What is my $5 going to do? But here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reassuring us. That your small little seed, which you gave, only for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with a clean heart, with sincerity, with only the intention that I want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to be happy with me. I want to leave behind something so that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will continuously reward me. I want to leave behind something that on the Day of Judgment, when I stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I can say to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I didn't have much, but whatever little I had, I gave it only for your pleasure. So please forgive me. Right, that small little seed that we think may not have any benefit at all, but we just gave it because we want the pleasure, we want to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reassuring us over here, right in the Quran, in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That this one seed, this small little contribution, this small little donation that you've given, will multiply and multiply and multiply, and will keep on multiplying until on the Day of Judgment, you stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you will have huge amounts of rewards, multitudes of rewards. And you look at all this and say, SubhanAllah, where did I get all this reward from? And it will be because of that small little $5 you gave. One day you just gave it, why? Because you wanted to get closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you gave that $5. And that $5 went towards the expansion of the masjid. And for the next 250 years, people continue to pray in this masjid. And for the next 250 years, that $5 maybe, you know, may have only covered a small part of the cement in the masjid. But you continue to get that reward. So there is no such thing as buyer's remorse when you give to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because you continue to receive multitudes after multitudes, and it keeps on going. Even after you pass away, you continue to reap the benefits of it. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاللَّهُ يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala يُضَاعِفُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, that He can multiply the rewards and for whomsoever He wishes. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then He says, وَاللَّهُ وَاسِعٌ عَلِيمٌ, that indeed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wasi', that He is the one who expands. Alim, He is the one who is all-knowing. In other words, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying is that if you give really with full sincerity for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows. Because in front of everyone, you may think that no one knows your intention. In front of everyone, you're saying that, you know, I want to give so that people will know that I'm a wealthy person, that I'm a very generous person. But Allah is reminding us over here very subtly, in a very, very subtle manner. He's Al-Alim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's going through our hearts. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's going through our minds. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not saying don't give. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying when you give, make sure your intention is right. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows what's hidden in the bottom of your heart. No one else may know, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows very well. And it's not just about showing off, but as we'll see in the next few ayahs, there's a few other things which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next ayah, He says, أَلَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ, that those who spend their wealth in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَى لَهُمْ أَجُرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ, that if you give in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then there's really three things that you should keep in mind. Number one, when you give for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then it should only be to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only for the rewards of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not for anything else. ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَى, and after you make your contribution, after you help someone out, this is not only for donating to the masjid, but this is for all types of sadaqah. Many times our family members will come to us and they'll ask us for help, and we'll help them. Many times strangers will come to us and ask us for help, and we'll help them. At that point, our intentions should be pure. That we are only helping to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, nothing else. So after you give that with the right intention, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَى, that do not follow up this sadaqah with man and adha. What is man and adha? After you give someone something, after you donate to the masjid, you come back and you remind them, hey, you know, I gave this much amount of money, I gave $100,000 to the masjid, you know, make me the next president. Or, hey, you remember that time when you had a very, very difficult year? And I came to your rescue, I gave you $50,000. You know, now I need you to do this for me. Now I need you to repay the favor. Right? So when a person gives sadaqah, sadaqah is given only for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, only for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sadaqah is not given with the intention of receiving anything back. A person does not give sadaqah with the intention that this person will repay me the favor. This is what man is. الَّذِينَ ثُمَّ لَا يُتْبِعُونَ مَا أَنْفَقُوا مَنَّا وَلَا أَذَى, that they do not follow up this sadaqah, this generosity, with reminding people of the favors that they've done for them, the sadaqah that they've given them. Hey, I did this for you some time back. Now I need help, so you have to help me. Why? Because I did this for you. وَلَا أَذَى, and they do not put people through hardship. Hey, I did this for you, so now every time I walk into the masjid, you have to stand up and you have to say salam to me. Or you have to treat me like a king. Right? So all these things, what happens when a person gives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? But then, their intention may be pure at that point. When they are giving, their intention may be sincere. But afterwards, you have to be careful as well. After you give, you have to make sure that you do not fall in this trap of reminding people of how much you've helped them out. You do not inconvenience people or put people through hardship just because you can do so. You can put this person through hardship. You can tell this person, do this and do that for me. Because you know the person won't say no because they're indebted to you. Or because this person may need help again. So you can boss this person around. You can tell them, do this, do that. Right? And the person won't say no because you've helped him out in the past. Or he knows that he needs your help sometime in the future. So it's not just during the giving process, but even afterwards, we have to be very careful of the way we conduct ourselves to the person that we're helping out, or to the organization, or whatever it is that we're helping out. So if a person gives for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then after giving, they do not remind people of the favors that they've done, or their generosity and whatnot, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, لَهُمْ أَجْرُهُمْ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Then for them is reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and وَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. They will not have any fear or anxiety. Meaning they won't have anything to worry about in the future and nothing of the past. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, that if you give and you follow these rules of giving, then inshallah on the Day of Judgment, you won't have any issues. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the next ayah, He says, قَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ خَيْرٌ مِّن صَدَقَةٍ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى وَاللَّهُ غَنِيٌّ حَلِيمٌ. That a good word and forgiveness is much better than giving sadaqah and then following it up with hardship and difficulty. Meaning what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying is that if you have two people, you have one person that may not have any money to give, and all this person does is he's just a nice person or she's just a nice person, and they have, you know, qawlun ma'ruf. They say good things, they have good manners, right? They're not really giving anything. They're just a good person to be around. And then you have the other person who may be very wealthy, and they give and give and give. But after giving, they cause that, they put the person they help into difficulty, into hardship. They give and then they go back and they remind them, hey, I gave this to you, so now you have to do this for me. Hey, I gave this to you, so you have to do that for me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the person who never gave, the person who just had good manners, that person is so much better. خَيْنٌ مِّن صَدَقَةِ يَتْبَعُهَا أَذَى. That person is better than the person who gives and then puts the person who receives that favor into difficulty. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not discouraging us from giving. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying is that if you give and you and then after giving, you remind people of your generosity, after giving, you put people through difficulty, then you've really just wasted your generosity. You know, don't expect anything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes it even more clear by saying, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, right in the next ayah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَىٰ كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ وَلَا يُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. That all you who believe, do not destroy your sadaqah by reminding people of your favors. Do not destroy your sadaqah bil adha, by putting people through difficulty and hardship. كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ. Like those who give only to show off, and they don't believe in the hereafter. Meaning there are people who do not believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are people who do not believe in the hereafter. They give, but the reason they give is so that everyone else can see their purpose for giving is so that people can praise them. It's so that people can say that, wow, this person is such a generous person. This person is very wealthy. He can give. So they give so that they can hear praises from people. They give so that they can have a status in society. They don't give because they are expecting reward and blessings from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right? So what Allah is saying, don't be like that person who gives to show off to people, who gives so that they can achieve a status in society, because these people have no reward by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تبطلوا صدقاتكم بالمن والأذى. They have nothing that they can expect from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There's nothing waiting for them. The ayah which we read just 2-3 ayahs ago, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, if you give, then this one small contribution, this one donation will continue to grow and grow and grow, will continue to multiply. This is not the situation for a person who gives so that people can praise him. This is not the situation for the person who gives so that they can achieve a status and rank in society. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَمَثَلُهُ كَمَثَلِ صَفْوَانِ عَلَيْهِ تُرَابٌ فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ فَتَرَقَهُ صَلْدًا. The person who gives so that people can praise him, the person who gives so that he can acquire a status in society, it's like the example of a stone on which there is sand. You know, you have, if you ever go by the beach or by the river, you'll see that there's special types of stones. These stones are very, very smooth. They have very flat surfaces. And they're very slippery as well. If you try stepping on them and you're not careful, you'll slip. Right? They're very smooth and they're very slippery. Nothing really sticks onto them. And over here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, it's like the example of a stone like that. A very nice, textured, smooth stone. And on it, alayhi turab. There is sand on top of the stone. You know, sand doesn't really have any weight. It's very small particles. Wind can blow sand away. فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ فَتَرَكَهُ صَلْدًا. So this stone, which is very smooth, very slippery to begin with, has these, you know, particles of sand on it. And what happens is, فَأَصَابَهُ وَابِلٌ. This huge torrent of rain, this storm, comes and completely cleans this stone away. Right? فَتَرَكَهُ صَلْدًا. The stone is left completely clean. There's nothing on top of the stone. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, the example that Allah is giving, is that when a person gives to show off to people, when a person is giving, and they're saying, you know, I'm only giving for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but in their hearts, they know that they're giving so that other people can praise them. In their hearts, they know they're giving so that people can say, this person is very generous. So that they can achieve a certain rank in society. Or they know that if I give this amount, then maybe 5 years later, I'll have a position, I'll hold a position in this organization. Right? Their intention is not only the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They have ulterior motives. They have different intentions as well. For this person, their contribution, their donation, their sadaqah are like these small particles of sand that have no weight to begin with. And on top of that, they are on a surface which has no, that can't hold it. And then to make it worse, this huge storm comes and completely decimates the entire thing. Completely blows it off. There's nothing, there's no remnants of it left. On the Day of Judgment, a person who has given millions and millions with the wrong intention, he will stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and there's no trace of it. No trace of it. They'll say, all that money I gave, where did it go? Where's my reward for it? And the reward, there is no reward. Because that person's intention was to hear other people say, wow, you're such a great person. But the other hand, you have a person who gave $5 just once in their lifetime, only for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That person's $5 continues to grow and grow and grow. And on the Day of Judgment, that person will have so much. Why? Because he had the right intention and he did not follow up his donation with reminding people of the donation that he's given. He did not follow up by putting people through hardship and difficulty. That I gave you this, now you have to do this for me, you have to do that for me. The next ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَثَلُ الَّذِينَ يُنْفِقُونَ أَمْوَالَهُمْ ابْتِغَاءَ مَرْضَاتِ اللَّهِ وَتَثْبِيتًا مِنْ أَنفُسِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ حَبَّةٍ بِرَبْوَةٍ أَصَابَهَا وَابِلٌ فَآتَتْ أُكُلَهَا ضِعْفَيْنِ فَإِنْ لَمْ يُصِبْهَا وَابِلٌ فَطَلٌّ وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. This ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is again reminding us that the people who give only for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ابْتِغَاءَ مَرَضَاتِ اللَّهِ. That when they give, they are only seeking the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then for them is the example which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already given us. That this one small contribution will continue to grow and grow and grow. So in conclusion, dear brothers and sisters, alhamdulillah, we've mentioned that our fundraiser went very well. Alhamdulillah. And as always, our community is very supportive, very generous. Our community is always giving, alhamdulillah. And thank you very much for that. But as a reminder, let us not be from those people who give with the wrong intention. Let us not be those people who give with ulterior motives. Let us be people who give only for the reward of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because even if we gave $1, even if we gave 50 cents, that small contribution will continue to grow and grow and grow. And on the Day of Judgment, that small contribution, that small donation that we thought would have no value or no significance will end up being something great for us. Whereas if we've given with the wrong intention, with the intention so that people can praise us, with the intention of seeking favors in the future, even if it's a $1 million contribution, it will have no weight whatsoever in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, it's something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will hold against us. It's something which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will use against us. And don't get the wrong message. It's not to say that you shouldn't give. The message here is to say when you give, give with the right intention. And if you've given with the wrong intention, then too there's a way out. Just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, please forgive me. All you need to do is make tawbah. And you just have to make sure that in the future, you're not giving with the intention of showing off, and that you're not doing what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying over here, that you're not going and reminding people of your favors. You're not going and reminding people of how much you've given. You're not seeking favors from anyone else. Right, so if you've done this in the past, or if you're guilty of this, it doesn't mean that, you know, now there's no way out. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is generous. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is forgiving. And all we have to do is make tawbah and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we won't do it again. So inshallah, with that being said, Jazakallah khair once again to the entire community for their generous contributions. And as you know that, you know, whatever money we get, whatever money we've collected in the fundraiser last week, it's going completely for this expansion project. It's not coming to anyone. It's not coming to me, it's not coming to any other board members. No one's taking this money. And as our Vice President Dr. Mumtaz mentioned last week in the fundraiser, that if anyone wants to see where each and every single penny is being spent, then we have a track record of all that. Right? All that is being recorded, all that is being tracked to make sure that everything that you guys are giving is going back to the community, so that inshallah you and your future generations will be benefiting from it. So jazakallahu khair. Barakallahu lana wa lakum fil Qur'anil Majeed wa nafa'ana wa iyyakum bil ayati wa dhikril hakim. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa lisa'il muslimin fastaghfiru innahu huwal ghafurur rahim. Inshallah, please move up. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله قال الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد عبدك ورسولك وصل على المؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات وبارك على محمد وأزواجه وذريته قال النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام أرحم أمتي بأمتي أبو بكر وأشدهم في أمر الله تعالى عمر وأصدقهم حياء عثمان وأقضاهم علي وفاطمة سيدة نساء أهل الجنة والحسن الحسين سيدة شباب أهل الجنة وحفصة أسد الله وأسد رسوله رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين Dear brothers and sisters, we have a few announcements before we finish tonight. Today, number one, there's two brothers in our community who have passed away. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Firstly, brother Jamil Khan, his elder brother Abdul Rashid Khan, passed away in Pakistan last night. So we pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on him, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives his sins, and that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala makes his grave, his qabr, a guardian of paradise. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on their family. Additionally, also, a brother who would come to our masjid, brother Muhammad Mas'ud, last week we made the announcement that he's in the hospital and he's undergoing some sort of surgery. This week he passed away. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. You know, this is a reminder for all of us that we can be very healthy, we can be very young, and there's always unforeseen circumstances that can come about, and it can have a drastic change in our lives. And if we're not prepared for this moment, really the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, in the hadith it mentions that the Prophet would remind himself of death all the time. This was something that the Prophet always would remind himself of. No matter how much we've advanced technologically, no matter how advanced our medicine is at the moment, death will always be there. There's no escaping death. And that's something that as Muslims we should always be ready for. Right? That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is always reminding us of death in the Qur'an. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when you read the hadith, you read the chapter on death, you'll notice that there's many hadith just, you know, reminding a person of death. And this is something which is the reality. Because this life is temporary. After this life is really for the hereafter. So, you know, all these are a reminder for us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on their families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them maghfirah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have mercy on them and make their graves a garden of paradise. May Allah reward their family for their patience and grant them strength. I mean, another announcement is that inshallah on Monday there will be an event at the masjid in Clementon. In the Clementon masjid, just 10 minutes from here, there will be an event from 5 to 9 p.m. They'll be having a number of great speakers, so everyone is invited. They actually have a program dedicated just for the youth. So Monday, 5 to 9, all the youth, inshallah, if you have time, all the parents, you know, encourage your youth to participate. There will be specific events just for the youth. So that's at the Clementon Masjid from 5 to 9 on Monday, inshallah. Jazakallah khair. إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم واشكروه ولا تكفرون أقيموا الصلاة.
الله أكبر الله أكبر.